All right, welcome back to another episode on the iStrategy blog. I'm Ruben, this is Micheal.
Hello.
Want to talk today about clout. What is clout?
Clout.
Besides the fact that we know what the definition of clout is.
It's a service to let you know whether you have any clout or not.
Online.
Yes, which doesn't directly translate to real life, but
yes.
But they have added, they essentially have an algorithm to, it used to be Twitter only, to essentially sort of get a ranking of how powerful any...
How influential
your posts are.
Mm-hmm.
And now they've recently began to...
aggregate your Facebook influences.
Yeah, so your influences and from Facebook and LinkedIn.
Soon to be LinkedIn. So you'll be invited soon to have those three powerful networks. Which would help, because there's some people that have a strong engagement on LinkedIn versus Twitter or Facebook. Now they have the ability to really get the overall influence of someone in those three primary networks. But what's interesting enough, and we'll link to the article, is a report, a business, I think it was last year actually, that actually uses this algorithm to determine if they're going to give someone an upgrade at their hotel, one of the casino hotels. So if you had a certain clout score, you actually would get an upgrade. Why would you do that?
Because if you...
I know the answer, but...
If you don't give them an upgrade, or, if they have a bad experience, they could proportionally sort of hurt you more than a lesser-known customer
that has a lower clout score, but also it's actually on the positive end in that
because you are the opposite.
They are hoping that when you upgrade and you have a better experience, that you would let your network know, realizing that you have a powerful
network.
Just got
a free, upgrade.
Yeah, so it actually pays to have a good clout score now, something that I didn't really pay attention to, but now it's actually gone to brands. They also look in and they're building an algorithm for, it's actually already in place for brands and how influential they are.
Yeah.
So, believe it or not, your influence online actually does pay off.
I wonder though, with Facebook being one of the factors, do you sort of encourage the situation like you did in MySpace where people just start collecting friends? I may be influential on Facebook in my little circle, but I don't have, but I may not have 1,000 friends.
That's a good prelude to our next episode. So tune in next week, wherever you're watching this, whenever you're watching this, and I'll see you next time. Take care.